After we have seen there, it seems like the plot will put us at the beginning of this madness. What can we expect? It's a really interesting point of view. We have seen this in the comics or the series. Can you explain this a bit to us?
Sure. The time frame of the game actually is a point that they really haven't explored in the show, short of just like some brief flashbacks. It actually takes place in the immediate weeks right after the Walker's kind of apocalypse happens. You know, if you're familiar with the show, Rick Grimes is still in a coma, and you assume the role of Daryl, and you're in northern Georgia, and you're having to travel across Georgia to get to this military safe zone. And so it's kind of takes place before the show line.
We have a survival game. What are we going to have to do to survive?
Well, you're actually going to have to do a lot to survive. You know, you have a car, or you can find different vehicles throughout the game, and you know, you need to maintain the vehicles. We can do car parts. You know, your car can conceivably break down. You'll have to have gas, you know, to keep it running. You know, you also have, you know, you can find other people in the world and survivors, which will give you some benefits. But at the same time, you have to find food to keep those guys happy and alive. You'll find first aid, which can, you know, has multiple benefits, both in the actual game when you're exploring and trying to find supplies yourself, as well as if one of your survivors gets injured as well. So there's a lot of different pieces there to kind of help with that survival aspect of it.
Can you explain to us a little about the zombies AI?
The zombie AI? Okay, well, the walkers in the game are actually really cool. They're one of my favorite parts, and we have a lot of really talented programmers, you know, actually working on the AI. Because if you think about most games, you know, you've got a guy ducking behind a table and shooting at you, and walkers are kind of like, I see you, I want to eat you, you know, that's all they want to do. So what we had to do was make them really environmentally aware, so they can see you, they can smell you, they can hear you, they definitely want to grab you, and they certainly want to eat you. So it's like, if you shoot a gun, that's like the worst thing you can do in our game, because even though it's more powerful, you just alerted all the guys who just might be around the corner. They might turn around and go, hey, there's something over here, and they'll wander around, and hey, there you are with your back to them, and they'll just grab you and latch on, and that's not a good thing.
No, it isn't. We have two main characters in this game. Can we play co-op, or we'll be able to play co-op?
Presently, the game's single player, and the reason for that is we really wanted to focus in on that deeper storyline, and a single player experience really lets us do that. So, as you play Daryl as you go across country.
It seems like a really interesting game. Uh-huh. Thank you for answering our questions, and thank you for all.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.